If you're anything like me, you have a lot of fond memories from your childhood. Maybe it was visiting the neighborhood candy lady or playing outside till the streetlights came on. Childhood was great, and I often miss those days. But childhood was also traumatizing, especially when you were sick. See, in our house, getting sick was an experience. Got a cough? You just booked an appointment at Mom's Primary Medical Center, where every treatment might be trying to kill you. No matter who you are, we've all been victims of home remedies, from hot toddies to the miracles of Epsom salt. But this is especially true in the Black household, where no matter the ailment, there were always appointments available with no insurance or copays needed. So this being a science channel, I figured why not take Black History Month to talk about some of the home remedies used in Black households around the world. First one up is VapoRub. Oh, the joys of VapoRub. You probably remember nights of being slathered with copious amounts of the stuff, laying in bed smelling like peppermint, old people, and sadness. But VapoRub could cure anything. Stuffy nose? VapoRub. Maha cough? VapoRub. Broken femur? VapoRub. I mean, it really is the miracle ointment, but what even is this stuff, and does it really work? The most popular topical ointment of this kind is VICKS VapoRub. In fact, the VICKS family coined the term VapoRub back in 1911, where it used to be called the croup and pneumonia salve. Very specific, but not as catchy. Invented back in 1894, VICKS VapoRub has been helping all of us feel a little bit better for 125 years with a mix of three main ingredients. Those are eucalyptus oil, camphor, and menthol, which are mixed with several other oils and petroleum jelly. It's these three ingredients that are responsible for its cooling and soothing effect on the congested. But according to my research, people use VICKS VapoRub for more than just cold relief. People have reported using VICKS to get rid of stretch marks, as mosquito repellent, and to even potty train pets. While these use cases are pretty wild, the truth is you're probably using VICKS wrong too. You wouldn't be alone if you thought VapoRub would fix your stuffy nose or cough. But the truth is, VICKS isn't a decongestant at all. It doesn't get rid of or fix your stuffy nose. VICKS is far more about feeling than curing. Believe it or not, your nose doesn't just smell. It can also sense changes in temperature based on the air you're breathing in. Your nose is actually lined with receptors that signal changes in temperature to your brain. One type of these receptors is called the thermosensitive excitatory transient receptor. That is a mouthful. These receptors are a family of ion channels that respond to cold or heat. Now, while these receptors can be activated by changes in temperature, they can also be chemically activated. See where this is going? When you use VICKS, that cooling sensation comes from specific TRP receptors that are activated by menthol, the same stuff you find in peppermint oil. This signals to your brain that the air passing through your nose is cool air, even though the room temperature hasn't changed. When you combine the cooling sensation from the menthol with the strong smell of the eucalyptus and camphor, you get the sensation that you are breathing better, even though you really aren't. See, VICKS doesn't unblock your nose or clear your throat, but it provides relief by helping you feel like those things are happening. Its worth is in helping you get a good night's rest despite having a cold, not actually getting rid of it. That's why in certain cases, using VICKS for too long or for the wrong sickness can be harmful. Since VICKS helps you feel better without directly treating the problem, it makes it easier to ignore the sickness. This may convince you to not seek further help or underestimate your symptoms. But that's all on the label if you really understand what they're saying. You know what else is on the label? Instructions. And after reading them, I feel like my whole childhood was a lie. Whenever I use VapoRub for a cold, I always applied it around my nose because that's where I needed the relief. Even though it made my eyes water or my skin tingle, that was just the cost of being able to breathe. I've even known people to put this stuff inside their nostrils at times. But it turns out, all of those are big no-nos. VICKS is supposed to be applied directly to the chest and throat area, which lets the vapors slowly make their way into your nostrils using the natural heat provided by your body. VapoRub is not meant for you to put around your nose and definitely not in your nostrils. That's because topical camphor oil can be absorbed through the mucous membrane in your nose, which can be toxic. Camphor can also damage the cornea of your eyes, which is easier if it's all around your nose. Also, the skin on your face is more sensitive, which means there's a higher likelihood for skin irritation. So that tingly feeling I described earlier is not a good thing. That's called skin irritation, or possibly mild allergic reaction. I've also heard stories of people putting VICKS on their feet and then putting socks on. Through all my research, I can't say this will hurt you, but I would find that emotionally traumatizing. Sticky jelly and socks sounds horrible. If that happened to you, I'm sorry you had to go through that. But in researching how VICKS works, I found out something pretty obvious. VICKS isn't the first of its kind. Humans have had colds all through history, and there are plenty of historical remedies that are quite similar to VICKS. For example, during the Atlantic slave trade, millions of African people were captured, enslaved, and brought to the West against their will. This also meant that much of their culture, customs, and medicinal practices were brought over as well. While many of their medicines had to be adjusted since the plants of their homeland weren't available, the common use of plant-based remedies remained strong among the slave population. One example is the use of Asafetida and Turpentine. Asafetida is a fennel-type plant that has a very strong scent, but is also a very powerful medicine. Also known as devil's dung, it was used to prevent several pulmonary diseases like bronchitis and the flu. Back in the 1700s, way before VICKS was a thing, slaves extracted the sap from Asafetida, which made a resin. Slaves would take this plant resin, dip it in turpentine, and hang it in bags around their necks. Sound familiar? The strong odor of the plant resin would help open up the nasal passages in a very similar way to VICKS, and turpentine is a great antiseptic, though it can be harmful when inhaled directly. With humans all over using similar plants to do the same thing, it makes sense why cold relief aids like VICKS remain popular. We've been using this stuff for a lot longer than you may realize, because it's really good at its job. However, I'm not sure if it's good at removing acne or being used as a childhood torture device. But one other good use for VapoRub is pain relief. It's actually quite common to use VapoRub type ointments as mild pain relievers for aches and sore muscles. This is because those same active ingredients I talked about earlier are also analgesics. Analgesic is just a fancy way of saying pain reliever, and there are actually two types, opioid and anti-inflammatory. VapoRub type ointments are like opioid analgesics, since the cooling sensation changes the way your brain perceives pain. Again, this is more about feeling than cure, since it doesn't reduce inflammation to provide relief. The main intention of things like VICKS is to help with the soreness that often comes with your cold, but I've seen VICKS and other similar products used a lot more ways than that. I remember the day I crashed my bike as a kid. I was going down a steep hill in my neighborhood when I hit a manhole cover, lost control, hit the curb, flipped over my handlebars, and hit a tree. Childhood was great. After limping my way home, I had a sharp pain in my left foot that made walking difficult. So I told my mom and she did two things. She boiled water on the stove and she got some Abenaki. For those of you who are uninitiated, there are many international versions of common ointments and drugs found in the States. See, in our house, instead of VICKS, I saw things like Tiger Balm, Rub, and Abenaki. If you know of any other VapoRub-like ointments around the world, comment them down below. But in my experience, VICKS VapoRub was more like the Hawkeye of the Ointment Avengers. Abenaki was Hulk. And that's no joke. It has more of every ingredient with the addition of methyl salicylate, which is another topical pain reliever. But again, all methyl salicylate does is make a cooling sensation that helps with pain relief. It doesn't fix what's causing the pain. Or does it? Back to my 10-year-old foot. After my mom finished boiling water and grabbing her secret weapon, she took a rag and dunked it in the boiling water. Yes, in the boiling water, because I don't think African mothers feel pain. She added some Abenaki to my foot and pressed the hot rag on top of it. Now, I wasn't the best behaved kid in the world, but I didn't know this is how my mom wanted to take me out. All jokes aside, it worked. Not only did the pain go away, but the part that was poking out of my foot went away too. Now, I'm not gonna say when you get in an accident, you should use VICKS VapoRub to heal your foot. I mean, I can't say that in good faith or legally, but I also can't fault people for their reliance on ointments for pain relief. Just like with Asafetida and Turpentine, there are historical examples of ointments for pain relief too. Dating all the way back to 3300 BCE, ancient Egyptians had a very robust medical system, including treatments for allergies and diabetes. Many of these treatments have been found through the discovery of medical papyri, which are documents written on papyrus sheets. These ancient medical records show the use of hundreds of plants and herbs for all types of ailments, including muscle pain. For example, in the Hearst papyrus, acacia, coriander, and cumin were used for their cooling effect on the skin and muscles when applied as a paste. That is because plants like coriander contain volatile oils called terpenes, of which there are many different types. Some of these have been well studied and have shown they do have analgesic properties, which means the ancient Egyptians had their own version of VICKS and Abenaki too. And that's the thing. In making this video, I came across so many different plants that were used to treat all kinds of ailments and diseases. While not all of them have been found to work, in fact, a lot of them have the opposite or no effect at all, there is a substantial amount that does. However, there's still a lot more research that needs to be done. There are plenty of things I came across that make claims based on anecdotal evidence or just one or two studies. With many of the medicines that we use today using the same compounds you find in some of these remedies, it definitely makes me wonder what else we could be missing that's growing right beneath our noses. No matter the culture, you don't have to go far back in time to find a list of herbs, roots, or creams that were used to treat all types of things. And this is also true for the Black community as well. Unfortunately, many of these recipes and remedies have been lost to time since they were passed through word of mouth rather than written down. While many of us understand why, if you don't, do some research, there's still a lot out there if you know where to look. In the description, I've linked several fascinating articles that delve deeper into the natural remedies used by Africans and African Americans that are fantastic reads, so make sure you check those out below. And while you're down there, make sure you tell me about your home remedies or other unorthodox ways you use VapoRub. I'm sure it will be an interesting conversation. Make sure you subscribe while you're down there and share this video with a friend because I'm sure they're using VICKS wrong too. I'm Lumi, thanks for coming to the Benchtop, and happy Black History Month. VICKS is far more about feeling than curing. Really, bro? Really, you just gonna interrupt my video like that, bro? Really? You're gonna interrupt my video? Like I ain't put you on Do Not Disturb because I definitely forgot to do so? Terrible. Like a straight rookie. Let's take this from the top.